On Saturday, August 30th, a mission team from Tri-Cities Baptist Church arrived in Nairobi, Kenya to seek the Lord's guidance in partnering with Crosspoint International to reach the people of the Machakos district of this East African nation. As only one segment of a trip to visit several countries, the time in Kenya was limited to only a few days. The team was met at the airport by Steve Bradley, president of Crosspoint International, and Dr. Jones Kalele, the minister's director of operations for Kenya. With limited time on the ground, the team only had a few hours to rest and recuperate before heading to the field. As the team hit the road, still feeling the effects of the flights, the reality of driving on the left side of the road in traffic that at best could be described as mass chaos seemed to keep everyone awake and alert, just trying to figure out how this driving on the wrong side of the road works. The drive proved to be interesting not only from the traffic, but also by the occasional spotting of herds of giraffe and zebra casually grazing alongside the road. In between the bumps, curves, and near misses, the Crosspoint staff explained their ministry and the work to be done here in Kenya. The remote village of Ingini, 70 miles south of Nairobi, is in desperate need of medical care. Phase one of Crosspoint's vision is to complete and furnish a medical clinic and staff it with local nurses who can provide at least some help in medical emergencies. The clinic will also offer a facility for use by medical mission teams from the U.S. to help meet the needs of the community. The first team to use the new medical clinic will be in June of 2009 from Tri-Cities Baptist Church. As the team traveled on, Dr. Kalele shared phase two of the project. On 10 acres of land currently owned by the ministry in the village of Ingini, plans are being made to build a bivocational ministry training center. This facility will allow young men and women who feel called to the ministry to obtain a four-year Bible education while at the same time learn a trade that will allow them to make a living upon graduation. These young people will be trained to be missionaries, evangelists, and pastors to go not only throughout Kenya, but also to other countries throughout Africa to share the gospel. Their language skills and cultural awareness will enable them to reach the lost in ways unavailable to Western missionaries, and their vocational training will allow them to begin their ministry wherever the Lord leads them. The third and final phase of the project in Kenya is the construction of a series of homes for orphans. The AIDS virus has left in its wake thousands of children who no longer have parents, many of whom are HIV positive. Crosspoint International's vision is to meet the needs of these children in the area of Ingini. Unlike the traditional model of one building with multiple dormitories, the vision here is to construct smaller, house-like structures that will house 6 to 8 children and 2 counselors. This design allows the children to feel like they have a real home and a real family. They will go to school during the day and return home to their house and their family every afternoon. An additional 5 acres of land was recently purchased by the ministry on which to build these homes. The team had a fitting end to their time in Kenya as they were able to worship on Sunday morning in a Kenyan church with the former president of the country, Daniel Moi. Daniel invited them to his house that afternoon to meet with them, talk about the Lord, and discuss their visit and involvement in his country. God is doing some incredible things in the country of Kenya. The needs are great. There are many who are hurting, many who are hungry, and many are lost. But God is working. The fields are white unto harvest, but the laborers are few. The team from Tri-Cities Baptist Church was able to see firsthand the opportunities to be a part of fulfilling the Great Commission in this part of the world. Our on-mission team stands ready to lead the way in rolling up our sleeves and getting to work to help make this vision a reality.